I'm Narelle Todd.
And I'm Essie Susan Smith.
We are the self-publishing author and marketing duo that has sold over 2 million books. But we didn't start out knowing how to sell books. Fast forward past many failed promotions and a lot of lessons learned, you will see how we went from self-publishing newbies to hitting the New York Times bestsellers list and making the USA Today bestsellers list 19 times and counting. We created the Get My Book Out There podcast to give you simple yet effective marketing strategies to increase readership and book sales so you know what to do, when to do it, and how to do it, as well as some tips for staying mentally and physically well.
Let's get started.
We've got a doozy of a topic today that we want to talk through, and that was how to ask for help even when you're afraid to. So, yeah,
and anyone that's the here? One I promoted. Okay, I got to bring this up. Out of all of the episodes, this is one of the ones that I said. So I get credit for at least one of them.
And I'm just going to say, so, you know, we're at 73 or so podcasts and what's that, the third?
I gave at least one.
Anyway, back to being afraid to ask for help. I'm sure that we've all kind of been in that situation where you've gone, oh, I really just, you know, wish I could tap into someone's brain who's been there or seem smarter than me or any of, you know, any of the things that we kind of think of. And one of the things that we were noticing in the program, that business program we've been running, was we would put out there for people, you know, participants to, you know, just reach out, say hello. And, you know, if you've got something you want to ask about, just ask. We're happy to help. And of course, you know, we love helping. So, and we would make this comment and it'd be crickets. There'd be, you know, nobody would comment. And we knew people were struggling with different bits and pieces. And each author seemed to have some different thing, yeah, that they were struggling with. But yeah, there were crickets. So do you want to step us through what you were seeing, Susan?
And it was funny because we did keep, you know, doing those, dropping those hints without just flat out saying, hello, here we are. If you're having an issue, ask. And it's that same old thing when I was teaching in the classroom, is you would be teaching something and everyone has got this fear to raise their hand and say, I have a question. And because they think, oh, my question is going to be stupid, or I should already know this, or everybody else knows this. And so one of the things that I used to have to really drill in to the students was the fact that there are no stupid questions. All right. If you have a question, ask it. Because no matter what it sounds like, there's going to be somebody else that's going to be going, oh, thank God they asked that question, either because I was afraid to, or because I didn't think about it, or I haven't gotten there yet, but I know I'm going to get there. So having those questions and not being afraid to ask really does help clarify everything. And one of the things that we were noticing was the ladies tended to, they were afraid to raise their hand because I think they were afraid like, oh, I should already know this, or I'm stupid because I'm not getting this concept. And so when we finally, you know, started really pushing them, it was like just watching a beautiful flower bloom, because they literally started helping not only each other, but we were able to help them. And you could see the light switches turning on. So it's just such an empowering feeling to, you know, overcome that fear of saying, I need help, and taking the initiative to say, you know what, I'm not sure about this. I may be on the right track, but maybe I'm not. So let's go over it again.
Yeah. And one of the things that I noticed, people would always start with, this is a stupid question, or some kind of disempowering
negative
comment. Yes, a negative comment first. And it's almost like part of the process, I think, is getting rid of that and just going, I've got a question.
Yeah.
You know, don't put a negative connotation on it. Don't put yourself down. Just ask the question, because the chances are that somebody else wants to know that same answer, or somebody else can help you and they want to help. And that's the thing that I've noticed, is that the majority of people want to help each other. So of course people are going to say, yeah, you know, do this or do that. And you might even get a range of different kinds of ways to do things, because there are so many ways you can do things. But that's okay too, because you'll get then to see all the different ways something can happen, and you can choose the one that makes the most sense to you. So by asking the question, yeah, you get this wealth of knowledge back.
You know, the different ways allow you to find the one that fits your business model the best.
Yes.
And the way your learning style is the best.
Yeah.
And that was one of the things that I liked about trying to push for the students to learn that there are no stupid questions, because you can always look at it from a different point of view. And you may actually open the door. If you look at most inventions that have been created over time, they built on a previous invention before that. So like the modern calculator came from the abacus, you know? And so everything is like stepping stones. So every time you ask a question, you're helping advance that new idea. And another thing that's really great about asking that question is you're taking the knowledge you know, and you're applying it, and you're teaching someone else. So you're actually learning that concept even better. You're becoming a master of that concept once you're able to take it and then teach it to someone else. And so, you know, for me, that's what it's all about. It's about paying it forward. If I know when I first started, I didn't know anything about any of the publishing. I had no idea about how to write a book, how to format a book, how to upload a book, you know, nothing about the marketing. I readers would ask me, hey, where's your website? Give me a week. Where's your newsletter? Give me a week, you know. So I would always tell them, give me a week, because I needed to go do research. And not having someone that had already been there and done that, I had to jump over a lot of hurdles. And there's some that trip me up. And so if I can help somebody avoid those hurdles, you know, then I'm going to do that. And not only am I helping them, but I'm also helping myself, because I'm adding to that network of knowledge. And I may learn something that they're doing that's new and innovative. And I'm thinking, oh, I hadn't thought of that. I could apply that. You know, this is something that's never should be thought of as negative. You know, always turn it around. Like you said, just ask that question.
And also, I think, keep in mind, a lot of people often will look at people who are further ahead of them in the business, mm-hmm. Or sell more books, or you know, any of those sorts of things, and think, oh, they're too busy, they're too important, you know, they're too something, I can't ask. Whereas the actual fact is that sort of the more successful you get, and those things, actually the less people ask you. Mm-hmm. So in some ways, when somebody does, it's like, yes, you know, because you're just looking to help. So I would say always ask. If you don't ask, the answer's no. Always, if you don't ask. But if you ask, you've got a chance. It's a 50-50 chance of them saying yes or them saying no. At least you've given yourself a chance for somebody who's further along on their journey to respond to you and to answer. And just, oh, what was it? 2 weeks ago, I had made a comment to you about, you know, asking an author something and going, oh, yeah, they won't say yes.
Yeah, you know.
And they did, and they came back in, what, about 5 minutes, I think, and it was
It was like, bam, and I was like, oh, I didn't think that they would.
Yeah.
You know, so that took me totally by surprise.
Yeah.
And like you said, it was always going to be a no if you didn't put yourself out there and ask.
Yeah.
Now, was there another author that I did ask and I didn't hear from? Yes.
Yeah.
But that doesn't mean that they're being rude or they're being, you know, they think they're too good. It may just be that they're overwhelmed. Life, we've got to remember, everybody's life's a little bit different.
Yeah.
For me right now, I know I've had a couple of people recently make a comment that they haven't seen me much lately. And I'm like, I haven't been on social media as much as I had been. And there's just a lot going on. And that's the problem, is I do have a lot going on, not only in my personal life, but I have a lot going on with, I'm planning on taking time out this summer to do a long hike. And because of that, I'm spending more time focused on writing stories that I can have released while I'm hiking 2,000 miles. But I've also been helping other authors. And I also did a Zoom group meeting with a bunch of readers. So it's not that I'm not out there and doing things. I may not be where I normally am. But the thing is that I'm doing the things that are, you know, not only helping me with my business, but I'm also helping another author who I'm mentoring. And I'm actually got a couple of authors that I'm mentoring. So that takes out time. And I value that time with them because they asked me. And I never would have helped them if they hadn't asked me. And then, you know, again, there's just different things that are going on. And I've really enjoyed, like, for me, I miss not having people to talk to. So when Coastal Magic did their reader challenge and I got to meet with a bunch of the readers, it was like, yay. So I was on Zoom and we were supposed to be there for an hour, which of course turned out to be like 2.5 hours. But it was definitely worth it. It was definitely worth it.
Keep in mind when you ask, be prepared for potentially an answer you weren't expecting. And be prepared that it's going to be a growth process as well, because you're going to want to put into play the advice that you've been given. You know, so don't ask, firstly, if you're not going to do anything with it. You're just wasting everyone's time. So you're going to be coming to whoever you are asking about a problem. You're coming wanting to know an answer or a solution so that you can implement that. So keep that in mind. It's not just the growth in yourself in asking for help, but it's then the growth you're going to see as you actually put that advice into action, because you never want to ask and then do nothing with it.
I'm glad you brought that up, because that's another thing is looking at etiquette-wise. If you're going to ask somebody, be respectful. You know, if you're going to ask for help, like you said, be willing to listen and actually apply it. I have come in some negative times where people have come to me wanting help, and then I've gotten, you know, I'm trying to help them. I'm trying to encourage them to move forward and do certain things. And then they come off like, well, I know everything. Not I know everything. They know everything. So I don't know what I'm talking about. And so it does waste my time, and my time is very valuable. Yeah. That is the one thing as an author that you literally will, you know, draw a sword and fight for, because time is the most critical element that you can have. And I don't like when, I love it when people come and ask me for help. I don't like it when they come, ask me for help, and then ignore the help that I try to give them. And I'm not saying they have to take everything, but when I know that they're just doing it and they want a magic pill, and then they get upset with me because I didn't say, oh, you just got to do this one thing and then you'll make $1 million. And they get upset because I didn't tell them what that one thing is. And they feel like I should know it. So that is a waste of my time. And I, you know, you tend to be more frugal, more selective, I guess, of who you're going to respond to. If you feel that they're not coming with a genuine interest, if they're not coming with a vested interest saying, I want to learn from you and I'm going to do something with what I'm learning.
Yeah, definitely. So all good points there. So firstly, remember just to ask, approach people, even if you don't think they'd give you the time of day, ask. That's the only way you're going to get to yes, because if you don't ask, you certainly won't be getting that response. And use empowering language when you're asking for help, whether it's, you know, online in a group or face-to-face with somebody. Don't put yourself down as part of asking. Yeah. Everybody needs to ask questions. No one knows everything. So ask, but do it in a really uplifting and a positive way for you, knowing that other people will also benefit from that, including the person you've asked, because it gives them a chance to help somebody else, which of course gets good endorphins going.
That's a good example.
Yeah. And then be prepared to do something with the information. Yes. And you don't have to follow it blindly, but at least consider what's there. And, you know, does that make sense to you? Would it work with your style? Does it work with your business model? Those are questions you need to consider. Don't just go, no, that's not going to work for me. You know, you need to be able to have shown that you've worked through it and thought about it, because that's respectful to the person you've asked.
And sometimes it's just a one little thing. I always say, if you just learn one thing that makes a difference, take away one thing that gives you a new idea or a new concept, even if it's just that hope, that drive, that, you know, oh, I'm fired up now, then that's the whole thing right there. You got something out of that, yes.
Yes, exactly. Because it may not necessarily have been the advice they've given you, but it's the thought that then went into how does the advice work for me? Well, it doesn't necessarily, it doesn't work, but what if I did this instead? So it's not necessarily that their advice isn't good or is not relevant to you. It's like there's always some way you can use that advice, even if it's to kind of start a thought process which takes you down the right path that you need.
Yes.
Yeah, questions are just so valuable. There need to be more questions.
Get you fired up and ready to go.
That's for sure. And if you have any questions, you know what to do. Just ask them in the comments below or reach out to us. Happy to help. Thanks, everyone.
Anytime. See ya. Thanks, everyone. Bye.
Hey, thanks for joining us today. You know we've got way more information we want to share with you to increase your book sales. So please come and join me at facebook.com. Get my book out there.